We stand firmly with Israel and its right to defend itself and its citizens as we pray for peace. We pray for the safe return of those taken hostage, the swift recovery of those injured, and the safety and security of Am Yisrael. Please be upstanding for Advance Australia Fair.
I stand firmly, but on weakened knees that tremble as I, like all in this venue, struggle to comprehend the enormity of the hatred that motivates people to take children hostage, to murder innocents doing nothing more objectionable than going to a dance party. Terror is called terror because it terrifies everyone. We've all been dancing, we've all been to children's parties, yet our worst nightmares would never concoct the scenarios that Israel faces today. And the outpouring of emotion globally as the world comprehends the inhumane savagery of the weekend's events is welcome. The lighting up of buildings in blue and white is being replicated all over Melbourne tonight, thanks to the empathy and support offered to the Jewish community from our state and local governments. I and other leaders have received calls from all parties offering their support and making sure we are managing. To them I say, and on behalf of the community, thank you. And this is only underscored by the strong contingent of MPs here tonight, Liberal and Labor, State and Federal. However, as we gather here tonight, politics is the furthest thing from our minds. We gather together because we are one community with indelible and eternal ties to the State of Israel. Those ties are sharpened now as we share in the grief of our Israeli brothers and sisters and share their outrage too, as we, like all Israelis, and indeed like all fair-minded global citizens, expect that Hamas is held to account and that the appropriate steps are taken to ensure that Israelis can remain safe in their homes, their communities, and also at their parties. While some appearing in the media have prevaricated in their descriptions of what occurred over the weekend, let us not be complicit in making truth the first casualty of war. Let's call out these acts for what they are. These are war crimes from an Iranian-sponsored terrorist group with a consistent history of perpetrating war crimes against Israel, against Jews, and against its own people. The scale is unprecedented. In terms relative to the infamous 9/11 attacks, Israel has already endured losses more than seven times those suffered by the US on that fateful day. In both cases, the victims committed no offence greater than going about their everyday business. In both cases, the citizenry demands a response that will restore their safety. As a community, we are not prepared to tolerate the disingenuously vapid calls that create a false equivalence between those who would murder innocents and take children hostage and a democratic state that defends its citizens. In that vein, we gratefully acknowledge the world's leaders, including Australia's, who have had the courage to support Israel's right to defend its border and its people. And concomitantly, we will not truck with those who in any way support Hamas or their homicidal allies and partners. What justification exists for taking elderly grandparents or children or toddlers hostage? What semantic gymnastics are required to defend an organisation that the Australian government has designated as a terrorist organisation? While we are angry today, I know that tomorrow we will feel sad. Sad as Israel begins to lay its departed to rest. Sad as we contemplate the further loss of life that is inevitable, unfortunately, as this conflict plays out. And overwhelmingly sad as we realise that Hamas's belligerent and violent actions have obviated the chance of a lasting peace anytime soon. And ultimately, this is the nub of the conflict, a conflict between a young nation that aspires to Western ideals of happiness and success and those whose only desire is to see that nation destroyed. When Israel's former enemies have sought peace, Israel has responded quickly and in kind. Growing partnerships now exist with six former enemies, and many analyses over the last few days have pointed out that the possibility of normalised relations between Israel and Saudi Arabia are the real pretext for Iran's endorsement of these unspeakable crimes. So we stand together as a community this evening, proudly declaring our support for Israel today and for whatever may come tomorrow. And together, with broken hearts but raised voices, we say, Anachnu kulanu Yisraelim erev, we are all Israelis tonight.
Temple Beth Israel and Progressive Judaism Victoria stands with Israel. Avinu Shebashamayim, Tzur Yisrael v'goalo. Barech et Medinat Yisrael, Reshit Tzmichat Gulatenu. Hagen Aleha be'evrat chasdecha, Ufros Aleha Sukkat Shalomecha. Ushlach Orecha, v'amitecha l'rosheha, Sareha v'yo'atseha, v'taknein be'etza tovam yilvanecha. Chazek et yedei meginei eretz kodshenu, v'hanechilem Eloheinu Yeshua, v'ateret nitzachon te'atrem, v'natata shalom ba'aretz, v'simchat olam liyoshveha, v'nomar amen.
Prayer for the Israeli Defense Force, the soldiers, including my own children and the children of many people and grandchildren in this room. Yishaberach Avotenu Abraham Yitzchak Yaakov, Hu Yivarech et Chayalei Tzva Hagana Leisrael, Ha'omdim al Mishmar Atzeinu, Va'arei Eloheinu Migvul HaLevanon Va'ad Midbar Mitzrayim, Umin Hayam HaGadol Ad Levo HaArava, Be'yabasha, Ba'avir U'bayam, Iten Adonai et Oyveinu HaKamim Aleinu Migafim Lifnehem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Yishmor Ve'yatzil et Chayaleinu Mikol Tzara Ve'tzuka, ומכל נגע ומחלה, וישלח ברכה והצלחה בכל מעשה ידיהם. ידבר שונאינו תחתיכם, ויעטרם בקטע ישועה ובעטרת ניצחון. ויקוים בהם הכתוב, כי אדוני אלוהיכם, ההולך עמכם, להילחם לכם, עם אויביכם, להושיע אתכם, ונאמר אמן.
This is probably the hardest speech I've ever had to write. When I first arrived here, 18 months ago, I had a strong sense that I would be able to feel at home here. I had been working for the Jewish Agency and living in one of Israel's most Zionist communities, the Arava. I remember one specific moment when Ido, my husband, and I were sitting on a mat in the desert with just the stars above us. And it was so quiet. We were discussing going on shlichut and what was important to us, a sense of community, that everyone knows everyone environment, and arvut hadadit, mutual responsibility. If we were going to uproot our family, then my three kids would need a place to feel like their second home. I knew Melbourne Jewish community would be this community, would open its arms to us and would have Israel just where we have it, right at the center of our heart. I knew Melbourne would be our perfect chiduch. As I'm talking to you now, my parents, Shalom and Tzila Elkayam, are sitting in their safe room in Talme Yafe, where I was born and raised, 5 minutes from Ashkelon, right near the Gaza Strip. My parents are in their late 80s and don't use social media. I had to call them yesterday and break the horrible news that the son of the close friend Tova, Oren Stern, had been killed. He died attempting to protect his moshav and his community, Nativa Asara, from the terrorists. Owen was 3 years above me at school, and our families grew up together. I wasn't there to comfort my mom or to hold her hand. She's not able to visit Tova and Miki, Owen's parents, to comfort them, as all those communities remain under fire and is still just not safe to leave your shelter. I used to work in the south. The south is my home, Shara Negev, whose mayor was murdered, Ophir Liefsten, is where I went to school. It is one of the locations where much of what we have seen happened. During Shabbat, I was continually texting with my friend Mazi in Kfar Aza, which is literally on the border with Gaza. It even has the same name. She was hiding in her shelter with her two young boys. Her husband, Tal, had left to defend the kibbutz. She sat in that shelter with her young children for 26 hours, hearing the gunshots of the terrorist and not knowing what was happening outside. After 26 hours of battle, the IDF restored control over the kibbutz, but Tal is nowhere to be found. Mazi and the kibbutz community were evacuated, and there's still no word from Tal. Many of you here are wondering what you can do to help from so many thousands of kilometers away. Most of you have friends or family in Israel, and it might just be that simple text message of support you send them, checking in on them. A text expressing your support that enable Israelis under fire to understand that there are communities around the world that are sharing their pain. Israel may have changed forever, but the Jewish community has not. It remains resolved in its support and commitment to Jewish state to exist, free from terror, free from fear. There will be a time to assess and understand what went wrong, how this could have happened. This time is not now. Now is the time for caring, for reaching out and support. I have full faith that this community is offering its assistance in all its forms. A WhatsApp message, a phone call, talking to the media, financial assistance, and solidarity meetings just like this. We are all one Jewish family. A family is there for one another when it counts. This is a mishpucha. Thank you for listening. Now I would now like to introduce Deputy Premier, the Honorable Ben Carroll, and followed by the Leader of the Opposition, Mr. John Pesutto.
The Victorian Government unreservedly and unequivocally condemns the indiscriminate violence to Israel and its people. These attacks by Hamas are abhorrent. We recognise Israel's right to defend herself. Some of the stories coming out are horrific, especially during a time of religious celebration for the Jewish community. My heart breaks for innocent young people at a music festival, taken soon and now held hostage. My heart breaks for Jewish families senselessly murdered after joyously celebrating the Sukkot or the Simchat Torah. Earlier this year, I had the great honour of visiting Israel and witnessing firsthand the friendliness and warmth of the Israeli people, laying a wreath at Yad Vashem and visiting what many people have described as Australia's gift to Israel, the John Gandel Hadassah Hospital, the rehabilitation centre, one of the largest ever, if not the largest donation ever. What struck me, though, was that everyone in Israel knew someone in Melbourne, Victoria. Our ties were extremely strong. I know each and everyone here tonight has a loved one home in Israel, whether it's a family member, a friend, or a colleague. I know you would have been in touch with them. I know you might still be trying to reach them. I know this is a very distressing time for you all here this evening.
Anything we may say is not going to give you the answers you may seek, and we recognise that. But I hope tonight you feel your Victorian community is right behind you. We are angry with you. We are concerned with you. Victoria, show support to the Jewish community tonight by lighting up our landmarks in blue and white right across Melbourne, Victoria, as a sign of solidarity with the Jewish people. We stand with you. We stand with Israel. This will never waver. I pray for the safety of your loved ones. I pray for all the families who have been hurt by the senseless loss of life. I pray for an end to this indiscriminate attack and unselfish attack on the people of Israel. We condemn it in the harshest, unequivocal terms. Thank you.
We too condemn them in the strongest possible terms. We pray for those who are dealing with the immediacy of the loss of human life and the abduction of innocent civilians, and we pray also that the government of Israel, and the IDF in particular, can take those steps as necessary to secure Israel and its borders and to return those abducted to safety. What I wanted to add to you was just a reflection to add to what Ben said a few moments ago. One of the reasons the Jewish community is so proudly admired, not just here but the world over, is I can think of no people whose commitment to the principles of justice, of equality and opportunity for all peoples is unmatched. The advocacy I see, the work that goes on in your community, makes me proud as a Victorian to look with admiration at the example you set for those principles. Hard-earned in the fire of adversity and injustice over millennia of mistreatment and atrocities which we have seen repeated in recent days. What you have done for humankind is something we can all be proud of. And it is that which marks a painful irony in the recent events, that of all people who are committed to uplifting all of humankind should suffer the base acts of these war crimes in recent days. And in giving you that assurance that we stand united with Israel and with you, we cannot allow these criminal acts, these horrific acts, to stand. We continue our march with you for a world that recognises our common bond of humanity, which you are exemplars of every day, both in these holy places, in our community, and across the world. We stand with you at this very painful time, but I want you to know we share your resolve for the people of Israel, the Jewish people, and the future of humanity. Our thoughts and prayers are with you.
Later tonight, you will hear the Jewish national anthem, the Israeli national anthem, Hatikva, one of the most beautiful and poignant national anthems you will ever hear. It is a poem set to music composed in a minor key. Hatikva translates as the hope. It references the hope of the Jewish people for 2,000 years to be a free nation in our own land. You will hear the phrase during Hatikva, Od lo avda tikvatenu. It means our hope is not lost. Deputy Prime Minister, Senator Paterson, when that anthem was composed, Israel was a mere hope, a dream. 75 years ago, that hope became a reality, and we became a nation once again. Today, Israel is a nation under terrorist attack. But our hope is not lost. We, in the diaspora, grieve for our families, our friends, our loved ones. We are broken, but our hope is not lost. And then we turn to our own leadership here in Australia. We see bipartisan support for Israel at this terrible time. that support being steadfast and unremitting. And because of that, we, the Australian Jewish community, know that our hope is not lost. I invite the Deputy Prime Minister, followed by Senator Paterson, to speak.
We will always stand with Israel, but more than that, we will stand with you, Australia's Jewish community. Because what happened this weekend was not just an attack on Israel, it was an attack on the values that we all hold dear. Let's be clear. This was not just another attack, another incident, another skirmish. This was the most serious attack we've seen on Israel in decades. And so the business as usual rhetoric is not sufficient. Of course Israel has a right to exist. Of course Israel has a right to defend itself. But much more than that, Israel has a moral obligation to defend its citizens and its way of life. Friends, sadly, we know that in the coming days and weeks, the outpouring of goodwill and sympathy and support that we've seen around the world will be tested. Because Israel cannot live any longer with the existential risk of an event like this occurring again. The response must be decisive. And when that time... And when that time comes, we will stand with you through what needs to be done. Because we are not fair weather friends. I know that many of you are fearful for the safety of the community here in Australia as well. Based on previous conflicts, that fear is understandable. I want to assure you, though, that our law enforcement, security and intelligence agencies take these threats to this community seriously. And they work hand in hand with the community security group to keep you safe. I want to leave you tonight with a sense of optimism. Israel has faced threats like this before. Israel is strong. Israel is resilient. Israel has friends, and Israel will prevail. Thank you.
I'm here to welcome tonight, directly from Israel, Rinat Kedem Bart. Rinat is no stranger to our community. In fact, she's a very good friend of our community and of us. She and her husband, Evri, were shlichim in Australia from 2014 to 2018. Not only did they become an integral part of our community, they became an integral part of our family. I know they love Australia, they love Melbourne as their second home, and I know that they are known and beloved by many in this community. Rinat, Evri and their three children returned to Israel to live in Moshav Gizon in Israel Centre. Israel Centre has been barraged in the last 15 minutes by rockets through from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem to everything in between. The phone has been running hot with red alerts, rocket alerts, in the last 20 minutes. Last Friday night, however, rather than being in their home in Moshav Gizor in Israel Centre, they were in Kibbutz Sa'ad with Efri's family, Kibbutz Sa'ad being right on the Gaza border. Kibbutz Sa'ad also, only a couple of hours ago, was subject to rocket alerts. Rinat, we're going to see you on Zoom shortly on the screen here. Thank you. We thank you so much for joining us here today to share your experiences with this capacity audience in the room and online at Caulfield Shule. And for you to be with us today is really special, really important. And my first question to you, Rinat, is, are you safe?
Hi, good evening. I hope you can all hear me.
We can hear you, Rinat. Can you hear us? Can you hear me? Can you hear?
Well, my name is Rinat. Thank you, Ginette, for that introduction. I want to share a little bit about my personal stories here. It's not going to be easy for me to speak, as Ginette mentioned, there are still sirens as we speak now, and I hope that during the time that I speak, we don't have to run to the safety room. On Friday evening, we were at Efri's kibbutz in Salat. Salat is one of the kibbutzim in Otef Gaza, the Gaza envelope, formed by Efri's grandparents, whose family still live there. It's one of the kibbutzim of this unbelievable enterprise, the kibbutzim and moshavim of the Gaza envelope. They were formed by chalutzim, formed by people who survived the Holocaust, moved to Israel with high hopes and ideologies, wanting to build a better home for their kids and for their families. We were contemplating whether to stay the night in Kibbutzan and decided, luckily, to come back home. A few hours after we came, in the dawn of Saturday morning, Chag Simchat Torah, sirens went over, and not just sirens, the sounds of bombs around us in central Israel, non-stop for quite a few good hours. But that wasn't even the beginning of the horror that we were facing. Efri's sister also lives in a kibbutz in Otef Aza. She was at her home in a safety room with the kids. Her husband was riding his bike in this area. He came over to stay with us as he had no way to come back to the kibbutz. So while rumors are coming over about many kibbutzim, moshavim, cities in the south being conquered by terrorists, he had no way of reaching them. Only in the evening time he could drive and get them to safety. Efri's parents stayed on the kibbutz. In fact, Efri's father insisted on staying in the kibbutz just until an hour ago when he was forced to leave. His next door neighbor, his brother, has a child with a disability and special needs, so they were very reluctant to leave his kibbutz. In addition, his brother's grandson, Dov, is missing since Saturday morning. I say thankfully they were evacuated because as we hear on the news, there's fire now in Kibbutz Sa'ad. The fighting is continuing as we speak. And this is something that is very important for me to stress out. We don't know yet to where this is going to escalate from the north, from central Israel. But right now, there are still people, not just soldiers, civilians, under physical attack here. My father's cousin is also one of the chalutzim that built the kibbutzim in Otef Aza, Kibbutz Re'im. He lives there. He was in a cruise with his wife in Europe when they got the horrific messages. He has three kids, one living in Jerusalem. His daughter lives in the kibbutz, and his son lives in Kibbutz Be'eri. His daughter's son is missing since Saturday. No sound of him. That's his daughter's grandson. His son living in Kibbutz Be'eri, Dror, and his wife, Yonat, and their two kids, Alma and Noah, are missing since Saturday morning. No sound of them. We can assume that they've been hijacked, but we don't know. I have three kids. The youngest was born in Australia, but my two boys are already 13 and 14. And for most of my life, I've tried to look after their well-being, their emotional well-being, keep them away from TV shows, from horrific short clips. Lior, my son, his friend from class, good friend of his sister is Shani Luke, the young girl that was in the party. And that now there are videos and pictures of her naked body on the streets of Gaza. Her parents still refuse to accept that it's her, that it's all over social media. And I need to have a conversation with my young son. unimaginable horror movies. Ophir Lichtin was a very, very good friend. We celebrated his 50th birthday. Unfortunately, the names and the stories that are coming over just show that the best people in Israel, the leaders, the Zionist Chalutzim, they're the ones we've lost, and it's a great, tragic loss. I want to say something about what's going on right now in Israel. But before I do that, I want to emphasize something. As I said, we're still in combat. We're not sure what's going to happen here in a few hours or tomorrow. But what we already know is that entire families have been wiped out. It feels like a Holocaust inside Israel. Horror. We also know that the kibbutzim and the moshavim that were under attack, some of them are completely wiped out, burnt. And I think that we have to already think about the day after, and about the aid, and about the assistance, and about how we can revive this unbelievable Zionist enterprise that was built and that is collapsing now. But what I want to say about the days that we are experiencing right now, with all the horror, with all the unbelievable pain, I want to say that we are seeing Israel's backbone at its best. And you all know that we've had very, very difficult years, and especially the last few months have been horrible for the Israeli society, with a huge tear within the heart of Israel that we didn't know how to fix. Well, what I can say is that there's no tear now, nothing. All of Israel is united. I'm getting hundreds of messages of WhatsApp messages, text messages, all day long, about civilian organizations, about people cooking, about people hosting, about people going to hospitals to deal with families of injuries. We are all recruited. And we are Am Echad. And also with the community in Australia, our beloved community. I know that a lot of you are feeling worry and feeling anger and are feeling painful helplessness. So are we. But we are together in this. And I feel that Israel's backbone is still strong. And we are focusing now on how to continue with that resilience on the physical level, on the emotional level of our kids and ourselves. I know that we will get through this, but right now we are still in combat and we don't know what's going on with our family and friends, and we are afraid of what's going to continue to happen. So on this note, I want to thank the beautiful community of Australia for being there with us always, and also tonight on these horrible, horrible days that we endure. And I want to send a big prayer for the state of Israel and for the people living here, for the Jewish nation. I know that we get through this. I just hope and pray that with the least number of casualties. Thank you.
Jenny. שהלב שותק, I pray for those who sadly have been taken hostage and replaced with their immediate returning in good health, please God. Mishemerach Avotei Nam Yitzchak Yaakov, Yosef, Moshe, Aharon, David, Shlomo, Uyivareich Vishmor, Vitzaret, Nedrei Tzva, Hagana Yisrael, Ushvuyo, Vekol Acheinu Hanetunim Betzara Ushivya, Avor Sheakal Mitpalel Bavuram. הקדוש ברוך הוא ימלא רחמים עליהם ויוציאם נחושת בצל מוות ומוסרותיהם ינתה ומצוקותיהם יושיעם ושיבי מהר לחק יודו לאדוני חסדו ולפנות ולפנותיו בני אדוני משפחותיהם וקטי אדוני וגויה מהם נקרא שכתוב אדם יושבו ובאו ציון מרינה ושמחת עולם על ראשם ונאמר, ששון ושמחה ישיגו, ונעשו לנו בהנחה ונאמר אמן.
אמן.
למלא רחמים שוכן המצאים מנוחה נכונה על כנפי השכינה במעלו קדושי Zayin.
Nishmotehen Beganeiden Beganeiden Tehen Menuchatam Lachin Baal Rachamim Yastirev in the Seiter Knafav Leolamim Vitzeror, vitzeror achayim et nishmoteihem Adonai unachalatam v'anuchu b'shalom Venomar Amen.
The broader Australian population may not be aware of what's happening in Israel right now. It's all of our responsibility to let them know. This starts with having conversations with our friends and colleagues who are not Jewish, but it also includes making sure that the media hears our voice as well. We cannot emphasize enough the importance of calling talkback radio shows and writing to newspapers to make sure that our voices are being represented. So many of you have reached out to know where you can donate and find resources and about what's, to find resources about what's happening, but rest assured that the community is working to centralize this information for you. There will be an evening of Torah, Tefillah, and Tzedakah this Wednesday night, hosted by the Rabbinical Council of Victoria, the Council of Orthodox Synagogues of Victoria, and the Rabbinical Association of Australasia. Details and a booking link will be published tonight. Right now, it's more important than ever that we come together as one community, one people, Am Echad, to support one another. We must create space for grief, for anger, for sadness, and for helplessness. We must also foster strength, unity, solidarity, and community. Most importantly, remember to look after yourselves. Take time off social media. Lean on your support systems and stay connected to the community. We can only support Israel if we also support one another. Am Yisrael Chai. Please be upstanding for the singing of HaTikvah.